I'm actually a meteorologist. Weather affects everything. I'm thinking about lightning and thunder. Every lightning strike will generate thunder, but at a greater distance, the sound waves will dissipate. So first we have the thickness noise, and that's basically, of course, this is the physically as the blades of the helicopter boom through the air, they're going to displace some of the air, and that, of course, is what's directed horizontally ahead. Loading noise, so basically there are forces in the air that would slow down the blade, and that's what you would produce, you know, the vibrations. Yeah, they're directed below the rotor. So, but the main one they talk about is tip vortex, which is when as the tip of the blade goes through the air, it actually air will flow around the end of the blade, the tip, and you have a vortex formed. And then when the next blade comes through and intersects that vortex, it basically sends off these vibrations. And these are the ones you really hear. And they're also directed down. It's not just the actual, the volume of the noise, but it, the repetitive nature. It's the one that goes boom, 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 boom. And that's what gets to people. If it was a continuous sound, it'd be one thing. But the fact that it's sort of a rhythmic sound, and that's what seems to really annoy people. And I said, this is also the one that produces the vibrations that even if you didn't hear the noise, you would feel the vibrations. What they're trying to do with the blue edge rotor blades is basically to not generate these, you know, the blade vortices, enclosing the tail rotor. Now, of course, originally the idea that was safety to keep, you know, the accidents were happening from people walking into the tail rotor blade. But also, of course, it's going to cut down on the noise because you basically are enclosing the rotor blade. So you won't get all this. Some of the sound, of course, will be actually enclosed. So besides the safety aspects and all, yeah, you cut down on the noise from the tail rotor. Now, of course, that's not the main source of noise, but it is some. Once you're getting into the newer helicopters and even the hybrid ones, the electrical ones, you're using multiple rotors, much smaller blades, much slower tip speeds. And so then you're not getting the aerodynamic noise.